Welcome to Analytics with Nax. This is another video as part of Power BI Tips and Tricks playlist, where I'm going to talk about drill through for an inactive relationship measure. If you have created a measure using use relationship DAX function and you have enabled a drill through for that measure, then it will not work if you are not properly configuring your drill through. So why it is happening and what is the solution, we can go for it. That is what we are going to see as part of this video. If you are new to this channel, hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon for notification. Before going into a demo, I would like to understand like what is use relationship or inactive relationship. I'm not going to deep dive into it. If you don't aware it, then definitely this video won't be understandable by you. I strongly recommend watching inactive relationship and use relationship DAX function video before coming to this. For those who already aware, let us proceed further. So I have a two relationship here, like fact sales contains a sales date, and I have an active relationship on that, and I have delivery date, when the product has been delivered, right? So for that I have another column as an inactive relationship. This dotted line indicates inactive relationship, and I'm analyzing here using everyday how much quantity it has been ordered. Okay, now you can see the item quantity I'm directly dragging and dropping here, and I'm using it. So I want to analyze same date, right? Same date dimension for delivered date also. For that only, I need to activate the inactive relationship using the use relationship DAX function. That is the main purpose of it, use relationship. So I've used the delivery quantity, how much quantity delivered, okay? So I'm using a calculate function, sum of quantity, and use relationship dim date and fact delivery date. I am making this relative active in this calculation. That is why use relationship will work. So let me drag and drop this one here. This will give me how many quantities are delivered. You can see the ordered quantity is different and delivered the quantity is different. And then let us take one such example here. I want to see the before going to delivery quantity. Let me remove this one. So let us take one of the date during September or let me order this one September month. Okay, let us take this 14th of September 2019. When I want to see what are those 30 quantities ordered, what are the transaction level details, right? For that, when you click on it, drill through sale detail. This is what we will do. And you can see what are the receipt number, the transaction level details I am getting it. So this is what a drill through function is, creating a drill through report. Already made a separate video, just go and watch. So this is the drill through we are getting it, right? This is fine. So what is the actual issue now? Let us try to put this delivery quantity that is created using the our use relationship calculate function. So now you can see here, I want to see this 32 delivery quantity details on September 21st. Okay, so everyone will have impression like when I right click and do the drill through sale detail, then I will get 32 records, but I'm not getting anything. You need to understand what is the issue happening here. Okay, basically this delivered quantity is applying a filter, right? Use relationship, this is kind of a filters. Okay, you're filtering based on the dim date, and this filter is applied in the calculate function. These drill through will not take the filters used in your calculate functions. So that is the core issue behind it. So how you want to enable that drill through details over here is like, there are two options currently now. Now you understand the issue, because when you click on it, this filter is not taken to the drill through report. What are the filters taken? Let us filter furthermore by Chennai, okay? Only one location. On 21st September, there are 15, okay? Right click and see details. It is not filtering. Why? Because let us try to see another example by having two datas. Now we have seen, like, once you have an item quantity here, let us do it again for Chennai. I will get the data, the total 13 quantities I can able to see here based on the receipt. When I filter for the only if it is delivered quantity, okay, then I'm not getting the data, okay? So if only item quantity exists, I can able to drill through. Only delivery quantity exists, there is no item quantity, then I'm not getting the drill through output, okay? This is the issue. Let us take another case here, which contains both the records. So if I have both, let us try to click delivered quantity, drill through sales detail. Now you can see I'm getting the output, but not for the delivered quantity here. Okay, I'm getting only for the item quantity, that is 18. So the interesting thing what you need to understand here is, when I say 14, I want to drill down for 17th March, I'm not getting this 14 details there. I'm getting only for 18. So what is happening here? Basically, drill through will take the outside filters, like, and the context filters, filter context, like this 17 is taken care of, I mean passed to the drill through report, this Chennai is taken, and this delivery date, as I said, drill through will not take the calculation filters. This filter is not taken to your drill through report. When I press once again this 17th of March, you can see here, and you can see the filters in your drill through report. It has taken 17th March and Chennai only. So how we can enable the filters start appearing here, or the data related to delivery quantity? So basically people think like, I am filtering for item quantity, then they will click on it and go for it. They are filtering for delivery quantity, they want to see only this delivery quantity results. That is not happening. You cannot pass the filters used in your calculations. Only drill through is taking the filters from outside filters and the filter context. So the quick solution for this issue is, like, along with the item quantity, you can see what are the columns I used. I used all the base columns from the table: sale date, receipt number, location, item quantity, item name, item amount, delivery date. Along with your base quantities, you also need to use this calculated column, I mean calculated measure, that is delivery quantity, which is calculated using a use relationship. That is the quick fix I can say that you want to include of. Now when you go to this particular column, okay, I mean to say the delivery quantity, when you click on drill through sale details, now you can see here the delivery quantity for these products started appearing. You need to understand the fact, like, why earlier without this delivery quantity, right, why when you drill through from a field from here where delivery quantity exists, item quantity does not exist, which is not appearing, because of this reason, because the item quantity is blank for all these rows. So that is why you got the empty results. So let us remove once again and I will see as soon as I remove it, it went, because all these things are do not summarize columns. Okay, do not summarize, where item quantity is summable column. Matrix, I mean this table also works in a such a way that only if you have entry in your measure column, then only this will start appearing here. So that is why there is no entries. So the quick solution, if you want to have, right, the drill through from your use relationship column, add that measure in your table as well. Now let us try to drill through for a column, I mean for records having both records. Okay, now let us try to drill through from either from here or from this item quantity, both will give us the same results. So now you see the combination here. The item quantity is 6, 1, 3, 4, 6, and delivery quantity is 10, and this is for different dates, right, on that particular date. So this is why it is started appearing for you. So you can see from these filters, right, 15th is applied, I mean from where we have drilled through, from here, right, I mean somewhere or whatever may be the dates. Now even from here you can drill through, the date is 14th April, which is nothing but for item quantity it is 14th April. For this it is the delivery date. Okay, delivery date is on 14th of April. The order date is different. So you can see all this delivery date is 14 and your sale date is on 10th. Okay, you need to compare these dates, will appear for 14th delivery date and this also 14, but the order date will be different here for these records. So this is a quick solution you can do. But sometimes what happens, people do not want to see both. This is confusing for people, like I don't want to see item quantity and delivery quantity, why it's blank. It will confuse people, right, when they use use relationship. They want to see, when they right click on this, they want to see only item quantity results, like over here. If they right click on here on 14th of March, they want to see only 11 records. When they right click on delivery quantity, they want only 20 records. This can be a requirement from the users. In those cases, you cannot go for this simple solution. If user understand this concept, they are good with some techno functional guys, the users, you can convince them. This is a quick fix that you add relationship measure here. If they are not convinced, no need to worry. Another quick solution is, like, you can copy the base measure and you need to remove the item quantity from here, keep only delivery quantity. In your another report, you can keep this one as item quantity and remove the delivery quantity. So sales details, you can put by item, or it should be by sale date. This should be sale details by delivery date. Okay, so I have used the same figure here. So when user right clicks, okay, he can see two options. They want to see sale date by sale date or delivery date. So out of these 6 and 12, what they want to see? If they want to see 6, they need to choose sale date. So now only 6 data will appear. If they want to see 12, right click on this and they want to go for delivery date, then 12 records will start appearing here. So this is how they need to understand the concepts here. So I hope you got the point, how you can handle the drill through with use relationship. You understand the issue and the different ways you can able to solve this issue. If you like this video, hit the thumbs up button and comment below for queries. And do remember that data is your asset.